Okay, my Unity download has finished. I hope yours has too, otherwise you'll just need to wait a little bit until it's finished downloading. So let's go ahead and look at the installation process. Pretty standard double-clicking on it. Of course, on a Mac, the installation process is very similar. You'll double-click and get a disk image, and then you'll do the normal things that you would do on a Mac installation as well. In fact, a lot of the rest of this course is recorded on a Mac, so I am very familiar with Macs. But for the installation, because the majority of people are using PCs, I'm going to be showing it on a PC. All right, so let's take a look. Has this window popped up? Here we go. Welcome to the Unity setup. So we just go through. We agree. Now, slow down. Don't just click everything. We want to check all of these boxes. That's fine. We want the example project and the MonoDevelop IDE we've talked about and the web player plugin, which you'll find out about later. But look, when you get to the destination folder, instead of Unity, I want you to call it Unity 4.6. All right. This means that later on you'll be able to install Unity 5 without it going over the top of this. And Unity will know where its version of 4.6 is. So put it in a folder called Unity 4.6. And then it'll go ahead and install. Now, this may take a long time. It may not take very long. It depends entirely on your computer. I suspect it's going to take several minutes because this is an SSD-based machine, relatively fast, and it's still taking a while. So one thing you'll also need to know about with Unity is whether you're allowed to use it for free. Now, it'll explain this actually after it's installed, but the bottom line is until you make $100,000, you're fine. The other thing to be slightly aware of is if you are being naughty and installing Unity 5, which by the way won't cause you too much trouble, you'll just have some changes in the code when you get to Block Breaker. But if you are installing Unity 5, then it comes with a free version of Visual Studio Community. So you need to be careful about the license rules on Visual Studio Community. But in general, if you're using 4.6 here with MonoDevelop and you are just an individual and you don't have $100,000 of revenue from Unity games yet, and if you did, why are you taking this course? But actually, in fairness, some people have been very successful already and still got stuff from this course. But look, don't worry, just install it, start making games. You don't have to report your revenue to anybody or anything at the moment, all right? And then as you start to actually publish games and receive income from the games, then start looking at the license terms on Unity's website. And you may also want to look at the license terms on Visual Studio's website if you're using Visual Studio for any reason. But for now, you are golden. Now let's just look at where this is going, where it's installing. It's going into C and then Program Files, probably Program Files x86, and then Unity 4.6. Now, you may have another folder here called Unity, which could be your Unity 5 version, but this is 4.6, and it's installing two things, the editor and MonoDevelop, which we talked about. So the editor is going to be where you'll spend a lot of your time, and MonoDevelop will be your integrated development environment, or IDE for short. So we just wait for this installation to finish. Now, I've got a challenge for you. So one of the things that happens during this course is we regularly stop you in your flow and say, look, let's challenge you to do something. So your challenge is to get Unity 4.6 point something running. It's your very first mini challenge. If you have problems, try checking you have at least 10 gig of free space. Reboot your machine and install again. But get Unity 5 installed yourself. That's the challenge. So with these challenges, we like you to pause the video, hence the pause sign down the bottom right. Go and get the thing done. Try your very best. And then unpause the video and come back and I'll show you how I did it. So go ahead and get your Unity 4.6.x running now. Okay, welcome back. So I am just going to continue my installation. So it should be a pretty simple question. Now, if you've had other versions of Unity installed, it may ask you, like you saw that prompt there for me, that a folder already exists, you want to overwrite it. Well, that's fine. The key, the proof of the pudding here will be that we can just open Unity 4.6. Okay, let's run it and make sure it runs. And then if it does, we have achieved all we need to achieve for this section. We get a splash screen, which is good. And we have Unity 4.6 running here on our machine, which is fantastic. So that's it. You can get to all the menus, etc. So I could do with just pinning this to the taskbar so I can get back to it later. And then I'm just going to exit Unity now, and we're good to go. Fantastic. See you soon.